Students, today we are discussing the acidity of alcohols. Myself, Dr. Digna Varghese. Alcohols show feeble acidic property. This is illustrated by the fact that alcohols react with active metals like sodium, magnesium, potassium, aluminium, etc. to yield alkoxides. Here you can see an example. That is, alcohol reacts with sodium metal to form sodium alkoxide and hydrogen. When ethanol reacts with sodium, it will form sodium ethoxide and hydrogen. Here you can see the alcohol reacts with sodium. It will give alkoxide, that is here RO minus, here H plus, and the hydrogen molecule is replaced by the active metal sodium here and forming alkoxides. Okay, similarly, if methanol reacts with sodium, it will definitely give methoxide. If ethanol reacts with sodium, it will give ethoxide. Example is tertiary butyl alcohol. Reacts with aluminium, it will form aluminium tertiary butoxide and hydrogen. Okay, here the hydrogen is replaced by aluminium 3 plus ion, so it will form aluminium tertiary butoxide. Okay, explanation of the acidity of alcohols. We know an alcohol. The acidic character of alcohol is due to the polar nature of the OH bond. But we know the alcohol is a very weak acid. Electron releasing of the alkyl group, here representing R group, which may be methyl group, ethyl group, propyl group, etc., which increases the electron density on the oxygen by plus I effect. What is I effect? That is, inductive effect is an effect regarding the transmission of unequal sharing of the bonding electron through a chain of atoms in a molecule, leading to a permanent dipole in a bond. The electron withdrawing inductive effect, that is known as minus I effect, but in the case of alcohol, it is plus I effect. Okay, so the alkyl groups tend to donate electrons to the oxygen, and here the electron density on the oxygen atom increases and thereby polarity of the OH bond decreases. Okay, so this makes the proton release more difficult. A substance is said to be acid, it will donate H plus ions generally. Here the H plus ion donation is very difficult due to the plus I effect of the alkyl group, and thereby decreases the acidic strength of the alcohol. Now let us take a comparative look at the acidities of primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. For this we have to consider a primary alcohol, that is ethanol. Its molecular formula CH3CH2OH. The acidities or the electron releasing effect of alkyl groups in such a way that the methyl groups releasing also, CH group is also releasing electrons to the OH. So the polarity of the OH decreases due to plus I effect of the ethyl group. This is a primary alcohol. Another one is isopropyl alcohol. It is a secondary alcohol. The OH group is attached to the carbon atom, which is substituted by two methyl groups. Okay, so here the methyl groups attached to CH of the hydroxyl connected carbon, The methyl groups donates electrons to the OH group. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms, 3 alkyl parts donates electrons to the OH group. In the case of ethanol, there is only 2 carbon atoms donating electrons to the or alkyl groups donating electrons to the OH group. Another one is tertiary butyl alcohol. Here you can see 3 methyl groups attached to the carbon containing OH. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms or alkyl parts donates electrons to the OH group. It's a tertiary alcohol. So primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols are here. So we have to say that the greater the number of electron releasing alkyl groups attached to the carbon carrying OH group, the greater will be the decrease in the polarity of OH group. So here in the case of ethanol, there is only 1 carbon atom attached to the carbon containing OH group. Here in the case of secondary alcohol, the carbon containing OH group, to this 1, 2 carbon atoms are attached to the carbon containing OH group. And in the case of tertiary butyl alcohol, here 1, 2 and 3 carbon atoms attached to the or alkyl groups attached to the carbon containing OH group. So the number of groups, alkyl groups attached to the carbon carrying OH group, the greater will be the decrease in the polarity of the OH group. We know in the case of alcohol, ROH, okay, here the electron releasing groups, that is alkyl groups attached to the hydroxyl group, it is more electron denser, so it has a tendency to attract the H plus towards oxygen atom, which is more electron denser due to this alkyl groups. So the polarity decreases, thereby the release of H plus ion decreases, so the acidic strength also decreases. Okay, so the number of alkyl groups increases, that means the acidic strength also decreases. Here you can see the methyl group, the primary alcohol here, secondary alcohol is here, and the tertiary alcohol is here. We know in the case of primary, here only 1 carbon atom attached to the carbon containing OH group. In the case of secondary alcohols, here 2 carbon atoms, 2 alkyl groups attached to the carbon containing OH group. In the case of tertiary alcohols, here 3 carbon atoms attached to the carbon containing OH group. So the polarity decreases in this order, that means the acidity also decreases in this order. So among the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols, the more acidic will be ethanol or primary alcohol, which is again greater than tertiary alcohols. Okay, so the acidic strength of alcohols decreases in the order ethanol greater than, isopropyl alcohol greater than, tertiary butyl alcohol. In general, we can say that primary alcohol is more acidic than secondary alcohol, which is more acidic than tertiary alcohol. Water or alcohol, which is more acidic?
We know the acidity of alcohol is less than water. Here you can see the reaction between an alkoxide ion and water. The reaction shows that water is a better proton donor than alcohol, and it will donate H plus and forming a conjugate acid, that is alcohol here, and the OH minus, that is a conjugate base which combine sodium ion to form sodium hydroxide. Okay, that is its conjugate base. So water is more acidic than alcohol because it will donate H plus easily. Thank you for your attention.